Hello everyone. So before starting our session for today, let me introduce myself for all those joining us for the first time. I'm Dr. Avni Jain, MDS in prosthodontics, currently living in London. So today we are going to discuss about jaw relation. So before starting our discussion, I'll just go through these steps for the fabrication of complete denture. So when you get a patient in which you have to fabricate a complete denture, you'll do the diagnosis and the treatment planning, and then you'll go for primary impression. After that, you'll do border molding and secondary impression, and finally, you'll do the jaw relation. But before doing the jaw relation, you need to do certain lab procedures in which you'll fabricate your base plate, then you'll fabricate your occlusal rims, and finally, you'll go for jaw relation. Now, for jaw relation, you need to take steps, certain steps. You need to consider certain steps. That is, you'll check the lip support and lip fullness, and then you'll check overjet. Then you'll check cheek support and buccal fullness. And then finally, you'll orient your maxillary and mandibular rims according to the plane of occlusion. Now, the importance of lip support or lip fullness is that if it is too much or if it is inadequate, it will affect the aesthetics of the denture. Similarly, to check buccal fullness, it is important because if teeth are placed too buccally, it will cause cheek bite. Now, how will you do or how will you check level of occlusion plane? So, for maxillary rim, posteriorly, your occlusal plane should be parallel to the allotragus line. So what is allotragus line? Your line from ala of the nose to lower border of the tragus. So your occlusal plane posteriorly in maxillary rim will be parallel to the allotragus line. And anteriorly, your occlusal rim will be parallel to the interpupillary line. Okay? And then you'll orient your lower mandibular rim, anteriorly it will be at the plane of the lower lip, and posteriorly it will be 2/3 the height of retromolar pad. Okay. Now let us study jaw relation in detail. So what is jaw relation? It is the relation of mandible to maxilla. So this is the mandible and this is the maxilla, and the relation between the two is what we are going to record now. And there are three types of jaw relation which you need to record. That is orientation jaw relation, horizontal jaw relation, and vertical jaw relation. Okay. So before going any further, we need to understand the importance of jaw relation. When you are replacing maxillary and mandibular teeth, you need to replace it in harmony with the TMJ joint. So this is your TMJ joint, and you need to replace it in harmony with the TMJ joint so that there is no discomfort. If, for example, you are not rehabilitating your mandibular and maxillary teeth in harmony, it will cause discomfort. Now, maxilla and mandible, they are related horizontally and vertically. So this is the horizontal plane, and this is the vertical plane. So you have to orient it in horizontal plane and vertical plane, and you have to do your orientation jaw relation. We are going to study all these in detail now. Coming to vertical jaw relation. Now I'll just do a quick revision. After the occlusal rims are oriented according to the plane of occlusion that we did just now, we will proceed for vertical jaw relation after that. So what is vertical jaw relation? It is the length of the face as determined by the amount of separation of the jaws. And it can be recorded in two positions: vertical dimension at rest and vertical dimension at occlusion. So in this picture, you can see this face is without the teeth, and you can see the sagging of the, and this face is with the teeth. So you can see the difference between the face, difference in the face with the teeth and without the teeth. So how you are going to record your vertical dimension at rest and vertical dimension at occlusion? So before doing that, you need to understand what is vertical dimension at rest and what is vertical dimension at occlusion. So vertical dimension at rest is from here till here, the tip of the nose to your tip of the chin. Now the space between the teeth, maxillary and mandibular teeth, is the previous space. So when you are sitting at rest, your teeth are staying apart. They are not in contact with each other. And when you are going to close your mouth, or you are not sitting at rest, your teeth are in contact with each other. That is vertical dimension at occlusion. So how you are going to calculate your previous space? That is VDR minus VDO, as you can see from this picture. So previous space, it is around 2 to 4 mm. Now, to calculate your VDR, what you are going to do? You will ask your patient to swallow or say M. And then ask the patient to relax, head upright, and then ask the patient to swallow and say M. Then you'll calculate the distance from the tip of the nose to the tip of the chin. So the distance from here till here will be VDR. Then you will go and calculate your VDO. Now VDO can be calculated by various methods, that is physiologic and mechanical. Physiologic and mechanical. Now mechanical, it can be recorded by pre-extraction records. For example, when the teeth are there, there is a vertical stop. But when the teeth are not there or they are extracted, the vertical stop is not there. So what happens? As I had shown you picture earlier, teeth are not there. So the vertical dimension is lost in this, but it is present in this. So in mechanical, what you will do, you will take the pre-extraction records by taking photographs before the extraction, or by taking impression and fabricating or making cast of that, and then or taking facial measurements before the extraction and keeping it as your record. So when you are doing your vertical dimension at the time of fabrication of denture, you can take that as a record and then you can make your denture according to that. Now coming to physiologic method. In this, you are going to basically check for the previous space. So what you are going to do, you're going to ask the patient to sit straight, head upright, and you are going to ask the patient to relax and ask the patient to swallow. And then you are going to make your lips apart and you're going to see the previous space at premolar area, and you are going to measure that. So how will you find out your VDO in this? You already know your VDR, and you know your previous space. So your VDO will be calculated by VDR plus previous space. So that's how you're going to calculate your VDO. Or what you can do is you can ask your patient to swallow and then close tightly, and then you can measure the distance from here till here, okay, with the help of a vernier caliper. So that is how you calculate your VDO. Okay, so now we are going to see the common complaints that you see in your day-to-day life if your vertical dimension is not recorded correctly. So for example, if the patient is saying there is generalized discomfort over the denture bearing areas. So the probable cause is that there is increased occlusal facial height, or there is lack of chewing pressure, or collapsed face, or generalized facial discomfort again. So in that case, there is decreased facial height. Or if the patient is saying that the teeth meet too soon or can't open far enough for food, that means your facial height, occlusal facial height, has increased. Okay, so teeth meeting too soon, that means you have encroached your freeway space. So this is your freeway space. This is your freeway space over here, and you have encroached this space. That is, you have made your denture more than this. So that is your freeway space that you have encroached. Okay, so now you have recorded your vertical dimension. Now you are going to record your horizontal jaw relation.